One of the main efforts in the study of intelligent design is the investigation of information content. The creationist theologian William Dembski hopes that probability theory can be used to devise a test that uses what he calls a complexity specification criterion to determine whether or not an intelligent agent has been involved in coding information in DNA. In researching the topic to do this video, I found that criticism of Dembski's work is so broad and rich that I could easily do a whole series on debunking his ideas. In this video, however, I look at one basic problem with Dembski's argument. Namely, he has no way to check his test for accuracy. First, a quick review of the terms used in statistical testing. I'll use the example of home pregnancy tests. A woman is either pregnant or she's not. The assumption that she is not pregnant is called the null hypothesis. Being pregnant is called the alternative hypothesis. The possible outcomes can be shown in a table. The test can be positive for a woman who is actually pregnant, or negative for a woman who is not. Tests are not perfect, however, and there is a chance that the test will be positive for a woman who is not pregnant. That's called type 1 error, or false positive, and it occurs with a probability of alpha. More on alpha in a minute. There's also a chance that a test will be negative for a woman who is pregnant. That's called a type 2 error, or false negative, and occurs with probability beta. The accuracy of this test can be quantified. If, for example, 500 pregnant women are tested and the results for 75 of the women come back negative for pregnancy, then the false negative rate for that test would be 15%, or beta equals 0.15. If 500 women who are not pregnant are tested and the results for 25 women are positive for pregnancy, then the false positive rate is 5%, or alpha equals 0.05. It's worth noting that for this test, keeping the false negative rate low is more important than keeping the false positive rate low. A false positive means the woman will at some point be disappointed or relieved. A false negative, on the other hand, could lead the woman not to take important steps like seeking medical care or quitting smoking or drinking alcohol. Now, what about Dembski's test for intelligent agency? How could he estimate the error rates for his tests? He could test things he knows are designed by an intelligent agent. For example, he could take 500 passages from Shakespeare's Hamlet and see how often his algorithm reported no sign of intelligent agency. That would be used to estimate a false negative rate. I have to say, though, that that's not the most representative example. It would be better to describe designs with code and test them. Examples might be computer programs, computer hardware descriptions, coded descriptions of bridges, bird nests, anthills, spider webs, etc., to test a variety of different kinds of intelligence. How would we estimate the false positive rate? We could take random strings of characters and count the numbers of times the test is positive for intelligence. But now, all we have is an algorithm that tests if the pattern is random or not. No one thinks life is based on random processes, so an algorithm that tests for randomness doesn't do us much good. Dembski himself requires that the information be more than non-random. It must also be specified. Dembski's definition of specified is not so clear, but regardless of that definition or lack thereof, we would need to test things that appear to be designed, but that we know are not designed. For a creationist like Dembski, however, nothing falls into that category. In his book, if it appears to be designed, then that is evidence that it was designed. Dembski claims his test is reliable in indicating the influence of an intelligent agent, but he has a real problem in quantifying that reliability. His test could get it right nearly every time, or it could be wrong every time. He has no way of estimating alpha.
Here it's worth noting that in this case, a false positive is much more important and contentious. I think Dembski knows that this is a fatal flaw in his argument, and he tries to cover it with a vague rationale. He says, "In every instance where the complexity specification criterion attributes design, where the underlying causal story is known, it turns out design actually is present. Therefore, design actually is present whenever the complexity specification criterion attributes design." He is, in essence, saying the beta risk is very low, therefore, the alpha risk is also low. That statement is contrary to all standards of hypothesis testing. In general, there's a trade-off between alpha and beta risks. For a given sample size, you can arbitrarily control the beta risk and insist on a very low type 2 error rate. Then you increase the risk of making a type 1 error. Dembski's claim that his test is a reliable indicator of intelligent agency is completely unsubstantiated. He has simply devised a test that gives him the answer he wants and declares intelligent agency as the cause with no measure of test accuracy. His methods are much like those used to find coded messages in the Quran, the Bible, and Moby Dick. They only convince those who already believe. I speculate that Dembski started out thinking he could prove the existence of God mathematically, as many have tried in the past. He has generated a lot of excitement in some circles with his talk of information theory and statistical inference, but people who study those fields professionally find his work confused and evasive. One gets the feeling the only purpose now for all the statistical gymnastics is to create a diversion. It's clear that specified complexity, one of the main concepts behind the notion of intelligent design, is based on flawed logic and the vague hope that complexity implies an underlying intelligence.